Hi, my name is Dee. In this tutorial, I'll show you some of the ways you can access resources in B2C Service using the Connect REST API. Those resources include collections of primary objects such as all contacts or organizations. Here's how you write a URL so that it accesses an endpoint that provides access to a particular object you're interested in working with. You begin with the base URL for REST services on your site. It looks like this. It starts with the interface name, then the path to your REST resources on B2C Service, which is /services/REST/connect/version number. The version in this example is 1.3, but you can use the word latest here and it would give you whatever is the latest version of REST. Now let's see what's at this endpoint using a browser to automatically send a GET request to the server. Here at the base URL is information on all the resource collections that you can access with REST. Names of resource collections are the same as the names of object types in B2C Service Common Object Model, except that they're plural in camel case. That is, all the words after the first are capitalized and there are no spaces, dashes, or underscores between the words. This is not standard for the B2C Service Common Object Model, but it's done here to be consistent with standard REST practices. Now let's go to a single collection, like all the contacts in this particular test database. You can see in the URL that I've added /contacts to the end of the base URL. What you're looking at here is what that URL returns, the list of all contacts in the site database, but you can see that when I request all contacts, I only get back minimal information on each one. But I do get the ID, and then I can use this href link to get the individual record at this URL. And, when I request that individual record, I get much more information which is formatted in JSON or JavaScript object notation so that I can get the value of any individual field, for example, the city field. But then here are also some fields that are labeled as links of various kinds. Those are important parts of the REST architecture because they provide discoverability. Here in the case of the country value, I can use it to see what country number 1 actually represents. Because if I go to this link, there's the lookup name US. Or, for example, if I want to see emails for contact, that's a subobject, a list type that's not automatically returned. But I can use this link to drill down to the emails. I'm going to follow the link in two steps. First, this one that points me to the list of emails where I can see that there's 2 emails for this contact. And then the link to email 0 on the list, the primary email, where I can see the address value and get the actual email address itself. I can also get to the values in subobjects using the expand query like this, which saves me a link step. Thank you for watching.